because I have duty. Abu Fatma, okay. Zoom okay, sisters in Zoom? Okay, you can see. Can you bring the mobile, the whole stand, yes, to the center? Yes, this enough. طيب, in Zoom, okay. Sisters in Zoom, can you hear? Inshallah. طيب. اليوم كم؟ اليوم second of May, ها؟ طيب. طيب. We start. كم عندك؟ عندك فلوس أبو فاطمة ما شاء الله. You have money? Do you have 50 KD?
Yes, inshallah.
Okay. No problem, we give you, but because for the order. اوكي ليت مي كول شو اسمه ابو ياسر لحظه اي ويل تشيك وذ ابو ياسر هي ديليفرد ذا فود ايرلي السلام عليكم ابو ياسر كافي 50 دينار كاكا عندنا 50 دينار يلا تصعد بس مع الكاميرا او هو يجي وهي يلا سلام اوكي هيز كامينج ها طيب وي ستارت ان شاء الله طيب السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاه والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى اله واصحابه واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله ما بعد سوري I forgot this sorry sisters ان شاء الله now you can hear sisters down the basement I hope now that they can hear, inshallah. Your family with you, doctor? Okay, please you check with them. They can hear now because it was off the mic. We can hear in the basement, okay, خلاص. They are okay. طيب. Alhamdulillah. طيب. Let's continue talking about the first man in the Muslim Ummah after the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله تعالى عنه. One of the hadith to show you the يعني how the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم بفاطمة. Okay. How the Prophet how the relationship between Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. يعني you know generally the companions or generally the companions. They don't ask the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم their questions like other people, like the Bedouin people. Why? Because as a respect, they respect the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. That's why Anas رضي الله عنه. Anas رضي الله تعالى عنه said in one of the hadith that, yeah, and the meaning of the hadith that we don't ask the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم as a respect. We love and respect for Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And we like that a wise Bedouin man, not any Bedouin man, wise Bedouin man to come asking the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Okay? Of course, it doesn't mean that any Bedouin man is rude or not polite, but subhanAllah, the nature, people who live in the desert, different than people who live in the city. Okay? But what is the meaning that Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu speaks in front of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم? Also, again, it doesn't mean that he doesn't respect the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. No, he fully respects the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, but because this shows you the strong relationship between the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى عنهم عنه Abu Bakr. طيب, this hadith نعمان بن نشير رضي الله تعالى عنه said Abu Bakr came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he took permission. Maybe he knocked the door or he said السلام عليكم, can I enter? Then he heard his daughter Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنه raising her voice. Okay, على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. يعني he said he did not say she was shouting تصرخ. No, he said raising the voice. There is a difference, okay? Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gave permission for Abu Bakr to enter. Then Abu Bakr said, oh, the daughter of Umruman. You remember we said the wives of Abu Bakr, Qutayla, she is the mother of Asma, but she was not Muslima. And the mother of Aisha, Muslima, Umruman. So he said, oh, the daughter of Umruman. And he started to criticize his daughter, and he was tough with his daughter, رضي الله تعالى عنهما. أترفعين صوتك على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ Are you raising your voice over the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم? So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم noticed that Abu Bakr, يعني, almost going to beat his daughter. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم came in between them. He wants to stop this fight, يعني, or not fight. He wants to stop Abu Bakr not to beat his daughter, Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنهما. Okay, so after that, Abu Bakr left the house, رضي الله تعالى عنه. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم came to Aisha, and he was trying to يعني please her and to يعني to calm down her, and he said, "Did not you see how I came in front of your father, and I protected you from your father?" رضي الله تعالى عنهما. Then Abu Bakr came again, maybe the same day or in a different day. So again he took permission to enter the house. So he noticed that the Prophet ﷺ with his daughter Aisha laughing and يعني, maybe chatting and smiling, nice talking. Then Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى عنه, after he gave him the permission, the Prophet ﷺ, he entered. Then Abu Bakr said, أشركان في سلمكما كما أشركتمان في حربكما. Okay, let me join you while you are in peace, as I join you when you are in war and battle. Okay. Then the Prophet ﷺ or his daughter said, قد فعلنا قد فعلنا. We did. يعني, okay, come and you join us. طيب, okay, what is the point about the virtue of Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى عنه? Of course, the virtue of Abu Bakr, that Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى عنه was talking in front of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did not stop him. Okay, which means that even the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم respects Abu Bakr. He has a high position in Islam, that he was criticizing Aisha, or he was trying to يعني, teach Aisha how to deal with your husband Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not say anything. Also, there is a very important point, yani, apart from Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an, about the husband-wife relationship. You know, sometimes, or maybe many times, if the daughter or if the son, he or she has a problem with his spouse, so he speaks to his father or his mother, wallahi, I have a problem with my wife, this, or the opposite. The wife complaining, my husband. طيب. So they give a great headache for the parents. طيب. Then suddenly, after maybe 1 week, after 1 month, the parents notice the son, their son or their daughter, okay, bye dad, I have vacation with my husband. Okay, mashallah, last week you were at home crying, complaining, and cursing your husband. Now you are enjoying with him. Okay, so subhanAllah, this is a very common mistake. If I have a problem with my wife, I go to my parents. But when we are happy, we don't mention anything good about that. So, yani, mainly, basically, Hassan, this is my room, the other one. Left, this is the toilet. Also locked? So, yani, we should think in a good way, and we should treat our parents in a nice way, in a positive way. If there is something nice between you and your husband, or I mean your spouse, you tell your parents. parents. Make your parents happy. You know the hadith when a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or Rasulullah, I want to make jihad with you. But when I came to you, I left my parents crying. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, go back to them and let them laugh as you made them crying. So our job as children to make our parents happy. So please, 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 yani, don't tell your parents everything not nice with your spouse. Okay, your husband, your wife said something bad, did something bad. No need you call them or you go to them and you cry and you tell them. Khalaf, they alhamdulillah, they did their job. Now your parents 60, 70 years old, khalas. Now they reach to an age that we need to serve them, we need to make them happy. So please don't bring any headache for them. Of course, I don't mean totally, I don't tell them anything, okay? It should be under control. It should be under control in a very narrow way. Not everything. So please, if there is something good, you tell your parents, make them happy. If there is something bad, something make, okay, and no need to tell them, house, don't tell them. So this is the concept of Abu Bakr. This is the concept of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an. He said, yani, the same thing, okay, when there was a problem, I was there. So when you are laughing, khalas, also I like to laugh with you. I like to enjoy the time with you. So this is very important point, brothers, sisters. طيب. Another hadith, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam ista'adhara Abu Bakr an Aisha. What does it mean ista'adhara Abu Bakr? Yani the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told Abu Bakr, he said, please check with your daughter and be fair. There is an issue, please be fair. Yani here, listen to her. What is the problem? If she is wrong, you should discipline your daughter. طيب. Then, and Aisha said, the Prophet ﷺ doesn't think that Abu Bakr will be harsh and tough with his daughter at all. So when Abu Bakr came to Aisha, he was very tough with Aisha, radiallahu ta'ala anha. And he يعني, pushed her on her chest, okay, and يعني, he said tough words to Aisha, radiallahu ta'ala anha. طيب. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam became sad and or upset. He did not like what Abu Bakr did, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Yani, he was thinking that Abu Bakr will speak to his daughter. Yani, you should do this, you should not do that. Yani, as an advice. But when Abu Bakr came to Aisha, yani, he pushed her. He said yani, strong words to his daughter Aisha, radiyallahu ta'ala. Why? Because this is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Before that he is your husband, he is Rasulullah. You should be very careful. Okay, you should be careful with your husband and you should be very careful with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Ya Aba Bakr, ma ana bi musta'adirka minha ba'daha abada. Oh Abu Bakr, I will not ask you again to be fair between me and your daughter. Khalas. If you are like that, I will not ask you anything to say to your daughter. طيب. Again, there is a point I like to mention that no problem for the husband to tell the father of his wife, okay, yani about his daughter. Yani for example, my wife comes late every day. I tell my wife, please, you should be at home before 10 p.m. Okay, sometimes 10:30. 11:30, 10:30, okay? And I'm telling her, and she's saying, inshallah, 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 and she's ignoring me. She's doing whatever she likes. Okay? So, I can't tell her father, if I think he is wise, okay, please tell your daughter, my wife, to come home early, or to come home before 10. I told her many times to come before 10, but she is not listening to me. Okay, so it is not haram to tell you the father, okay, about the problems or something, yani simple. But again, if you think he is wise, if you think he is wise, if you think that he will interfere the problem in a nice way. Because what we notice that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Abu Bakr, but when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam noticed the way of Abu Bakr, he said, "Khalas, I will not tell you again. I will not tell you again." So what is the meaning? Is it allowed to tell my father-in-law? Yes, this is allowed if there is a problem. طيب. But is it wajib? Is it haram? It is allowed. Okay, what does it mean it is allowed? I mean, it depends. If you think he is wise man, طيب, he can listen, he can give a nice advice, you tell him. But if you think that he's not wise, and he will create more troubles, no need to tell him. طيب. Another hadith also about again, this hadith shows you the relationship between the Prophet ﷺ and Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr has a strong relationship. I mean, the Prophet ﷺ respects Abu Bakr a lot. رضي الله تعالى عنه عليه الصلاة والسلام. طيب. عن أنس رضي الله تعالى عنه قال, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم had 9 wives, and he was fair with his wife every night with one wife every night. طيب. So this means that every 9 days he will come to the same wife. طيب. So they used to state all of them, the 9 wives, في بيت التي يأتيها. Okay, so if tonight is the night of Hafsa, for example, so all the wives come to the house of Hafsa. Zainab bin Jahsh, Zainab bin Khuzaymah, Aisha, Maymuna bin Tahar, all of them come in the house of Aisha to meet the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to chat with him. Okay, for some time, maybe for 1 hour, half an hour, then they leave. All of them except Hafsa. And to have the night with Hafsa. Tomorrow, the night of, for example, Salama. Khalas. All of them come to the house of Salama. طيب, to chat with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, maybe to have a dinner, but not to touch anyone of them except Salama. طيب, he was fair. So this is also important. We should say this, maybe some of you now are thinking to have another wife, طيب, or maybe some of you already have another wife. I will not make trouble. خلاص. I am okay because my wife is not listening, but some of you, your wife's here. So it is your problem. And also tonight, I'm not going home because I have night duty. So already I'm outside the house. طيب. It is very important to know what are the rules of having a second wife. Because what is the problem? Some of the brothers who have second wife or third wife, they don't have rules of that. So yeah, they don't know how to. He thinks that, خلاص, if I have second wife, it means the full day, 24 hours with the first wife today. And tomorrow, 24 hours with the second. I don't meet the first. Who said that? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was meeting all of them. The issue is with the night. Okay, to have the relationship at night. This is the issue. Okay, this is the main thing. But for example, if you have children from this wife and this wife, okay, you can drop both of them, the children from this wife and the second wife. Okay, the issue is at night. You can also only stay with one wife, but to have the dinner together, okay, to chat together, no problem with that. طيب. So what happened? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam put his hand on Zainab. Okay, maybe he was shaking hand with Zainab, or maybe he's putting his hand on the shoulder of Zainab, chatting or playing with her. Then Aisha said, it was the night of Aisha. Then Aisha said, "Oh Rasulullah, this is Zainab." Okay, also they are here. Okay, only to chat, but not to touch. It is my night, my house. طيب. Or some scholars said, it means that the Prophet ﷺ was thinking that this is Aisha because it was dark. It was dark, no light maybe, or very weak light. So he was not recognizing which is which. طيب. So she said, "Oh, so this is Zainab, not I, it is not me." Okay. Then Zainab said one word, Aisha. So they started to fight. Then it was the time of the Salah. It was the time of the Salah. Yes. So أقيمت الصلاة. Then Abu Bakr was going there. So, where is the house of Aisha? Attached to the masjid. So Abu Bakr heard that. This is my daughter. My daughter fighting. Then Abu Bakr said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because خلاص they gave the iqama. Then the Abu Bakr said, O Rasulullah, come out to the salah, this time of salah. وَحْسُ فِي أَفْوَاهِنَا التُرَابِ and put the sand in their mouth. They are fighting. You'll be late. The Muslims waiting for you for the salah. And these women are fighting. Put the sand in their mouth. Okay, come to the salah, O Rasulullah. So, when Aisha heard, this is my father, oh, خلاص, I'm in trouble. She said, now, Rasulullah will finish his salah. And my dad will come and yani he will do so and so with me. Because she knows the story. Subhanallah. And yes, this happened. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam finished the salah, Abu Bakr came to Aisha وَقَالَ لَهَا قَوْلًا شَدِيدًا and he was harsh in his speech with Aisha. Are you doing this with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Shouting and fighting with your يعني with Zainab, where is the respect for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? So يعني again, if you notice that, usually who is speaking in the presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Abu Bakr, radiyallahu ta'ala an. Abu Bakr was a jealous man, يعني the good jealousy. I mean the good jealousy, غيرة on his women. One of the wives of Abu Bakr. We said قتيلة أم رومان أسماء بنت عميس صح؟ أسماء بنت عميس but أسماء بنت عميس later when after the death of not حمزة جعفر بن أبي طالب okay جعفر بن أبي طالب رضي الله was killed in which battle مؤتة سبحان الله the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم chose three leaders for this battle. What does it mean he chose three leaders? Not at the same time. No, you are the leader of the army. After you, it means if you are killed, this man. So he chose three, subhanallah. But subhanallah, all of them were killed in the same battle. Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, Abdullah ibn Rawaha, Zayd ibn Haritha. زيد بن حارثة okay. Three of them سبحان الله killed جعفر وابي طالب زيد بن حارثة and عبد الله بن رواحة then who took the leadership of the Muslim army خالد بن وليد سبحان he was a new Muslim خالد بن وليد because مؤتة was at the end of the 8th year okay. So after his death جعفر بن أبي طالب his wife was أسماء بنت عميس so after that أبو بكر married أسماء بنت عميس طيب عبد الله بن عمرو العاص said رضي الله تعالى عنهما some people from بني هاشم came to the house of أبو بكر and his wife أسماء was there then أبو بكر يعني when أبو بكر came he found this man with his wife أسماء بنت عميس then he went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, O Rasulullah, when I came home, I found my wife and there are men from Bani Hashim. And I did not see any problem. It was okay. But يعني, I have a feeling that my wife with men, not mahram, not one man, men. Okay? Because the narration said, nafaran Bani Hashim. It means plural, yeah, more than two. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ بَرَّأَهَا مِنْ ذَلِكَ Which means, don't worry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made your wife free from that. He means what? He means adultery. No, don't think that she did adultery with them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected your wife from adultery. So this is a great virtue for Asma bint Umays radiyallahu ta'ala anha. This is a great virtue for Asma bint Umays radiyallahu ta'ala anha. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after that, he gave a khutbah. He gave a speech. And he said, لا يدخلن رجل بعد يوم هذا على مغيبة إلا ومعه رجل أو اثنان. It is not allowed for a man to enter a house, okay, which has a woman. What is مغيبة? That her husband is traveling. Or he's absent, not at home. It is not allowed for a man to enter except with another man. يعني. One man, this is not allowed, haram. Okay, man with a woman. Not mahram, haram. Khalwa, the shaitan will be the third. But if there are two men or more, this is okay. But also the scholars, what they say, if they are good men, يعني, you trust them. Because you know, sometimes three or four, but all of them bad people. So you should not allow them to enter the house. So يعني, we should be careful, you know, sometimes your wife alone at home, or maybe with kids, boys, okay, three, four, 7 years old. They are not mahram, okay, and you need to fix something at home, okay. Jalal, please 50 KD for Abu Fatma. Abu Fatma here, okay. يعني they want to fix something, okay, a carpenter or for the toilet. No, you don't give them the permission. You say, no, this is not khalwa. Okay, it is not only one man, two or three. But you don't know them. You got the number from the internet. You don't know who are they, Muslims, non-Muslims, good, bad. Don't give the permission. Tell them, wait. I know, you know, so, you know, sometimes when they come home, okay, this is very common. Okay, you call someone to fix something at home. Okay, you tell him, brother, please come after 4 because I reach home 4 from work. 2:30 he's calling you. Baba, I'm outside. Habibi, I told you after 4. You are coming 2:30. Why? Because he finished his work. So yalla. So don't feel that I should give him the permission to enter the house. You tell him, please, you wait. I told you 4, halas. What to do? This is your problem, not my problem. Okay? So please don't give permission. Yani for strange men to enter the house, if your wife there or your daughter. So you should be careful because, you know, sometimes you notice people, yani they don't care about this point. It is a very important point. No, what is the problem? Okay, maybe at home your daughter, she's 13 years old, 14 years old, alone. No problem. This is old man. He will come only to put this or to, it is only 5 minutes. No. Don't give the chance for shaitan. Be careful. طيب. So this is wife. Another hadith about also one of the virtues of Abu Bakr. And Aad ibn Amr radiallahu ta'ala an that Abu Sufyan radiallahu ta'ala an was walking and there this was in the in the 8th year, just before Islam of Abu Sufyan. He was not Muslim that time. So there was Salman Farisi, Suhaib al-Rumi, and Bilal. Salman, Suhaib, Bilal. Who are Salman, Suhaib, Bilal? Bilal, he was a slave, and Abu Bakr freed him. Suhaib also, Salman, long story. طيب. I mean, they are not leaders of Quraysh, but they are Muslims, great Muslims, no doubt. So, when they saw Abu Sufyan, he was not Muslim. They said, "Lam ta'khud suyufana haqqaha min hadha ar-rajul." Said, "Our swords did not do their job toward the neck of this man." What do they mean? They mean we should kill him, but he escaped from killing because. يعني خلاص finished. The war finished. Mecca conquest happened without fight, without a big fight. So they said, they were feeling sorry, why we do not kill this man? subhanAllah, this great enemy of Islam. So Abu Bakr heard them. He said, are you saying this to one of the leaders of Quraysh? Are you saying this to one of the leaders of Quraysh? طيب. Then Abu Bakr immediately went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, oh Rasulullah, I saw Salman, Bilal, Salman, Bilal and Suhaib saying this to Abu Sufyan. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, oh Abu Bakr, you made them angry? If you made them angry, then Allah will be angry because of them, because you made them angry. Allah will be angry also on you. طيب. Why? Because yes, Abu Sufyan, he is one of the leaders of Quraysh, but he is not Muslim at that time. And they are Muslims. So they are, يعني, and all of them from Muhajirin. يعني, sorry, not from Muhajirin. Suhaib is from Muhajirin. Suhaib, radiallahu ta'ala. You should not make them angry. They are Muslims. Immediately Abu Bakr went to them. Sorry, my brothers. Have I made you angry? They said, لا يغفر الله لك يا أخي. No, at all. May Allah forgive you. يعني, because they know what is the level of Abu Bakr in Islam. No one likes to make him angry. خلاص. Whatever you say, we are okay with that. طيب. Another hadith. This is a very important hadith. Abdullah ibn Zam'ah said, رضي الله عنه, when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم became ill, and some Muslims were there. This is at the end of his life, صلى الله عليه وسلم. You know, for a few days, he was not going to the masjid. He was not praying the jama'ah. And of course, when we say the masjid, it doesn't mean يعني 500 meters. It is only a few steps, maybe 10, 20 steps from his house to the musalla of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. So some people were sick, sorry, were visiting him. Then Bilal came telling them about the salah. Oh, Rasulullah, this time salah. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, مروا من يصلي بالناس. Tell someone to lead the prayer. He did not mention any name. Tell someone to lead the salah. Then Abdullah ibn Zam'ah went out. Then he noticed Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه. وكان أبو بكر غائبا. And Abu Bakr was absent. He was not there. Then Abdullah ibn Zam'ah said, oh Umar, please, you lead the salah. يعني, subhanAllah, it was khas, common among all the companions. Number one, Abu Bakr. Number two, Umar. خلاص. It was common. Not only among the companions, also among the mushriks. Okay, I think we mentioned the hadith more than one time when, you know, after at the end of battle of Uhud, okay, Abu Sufyan, he was the leader, and he was not Muslim that time. He said, Afikum Rasulullah? Is there Rasulullah? Or, sorry, he said, Afikum Muhammad? He will not say Rasulullah, he will say Muhammad. He said, Muhammad is there? Muhammad is there? He repeated three times. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, don't answer. Then he said, Abu Bakr is there? Then he said, Umar is there? So the scholar said, even Abu Sufyan, when he was kafir, knows that number one, Abu Bakr, after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Number two, Umar. So it is not at all, it is not an issue of discussion. We as Muslims, we should not discuss who is better, Abu Bakr or Umar or Uthman. It is clear, خلاص, 100%. Abu Bakr, then Umar, then Uthman. خلاص, finish. طيب. So, Abu Bakr was absent. Then he said to Umar, please, you lead the salah. Then Umar, he went to the place of Imam. Allahu Akbar. Okay, they are next to him, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, on his bed. He heard Abu Bakr. Sorry, he heard, this is Umar, because it was common that his voice, mashallah, loud. This is his nature, yeah, subhanAllah. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam heard Umar, he said, where is Abu Bakr? Yani, when I told you that someone should lead the salah, it is known, Abu Bakr. Where is Abu Bakr? Ayna Abu Bakr? Ya'ba Allah, والمسلمون يأبى الله والمسلمون ذلك. Allah refuses and also the Muslims refuse. Allah refuses and also the Muslims refuse. يعني they refuse anyone other than Abu Bakr to lead the salah. What is this? طيب. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, tell Abu Bakr to lead the salah. Aisha said, oh Rasulullah, my Abu Bakr is a very soft man. When he start the salah, he will start to cry. خلاص. It's better Umar رضي الله تعالى to lead the salah. طيب. He cannot lead the salah. He cannot lead the salah. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, tell Abu Bakr to lead the salah. And she repeated the same thing. Oh Rasulullah, he is very soft. He cannot lead the salah. He will cry like this. طيب. عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها she went to حفصة. She tried with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now she went to حفصة and she told حفصة, please حفصة, go and tell the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. حفصة is wife of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, daughter of Umar. Oh حفصة, please go to tell the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that Abu Bakr, if he leads the salah, he starts to cry, and when he cries, people cannot hear the recitation of Quran. So recommend the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to tell Umar to lead the salah. So Hafsa went, oh Rasulullah, Abu Bakr is very soft, when he leads people cannot hear his recitation. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ma يعني خلاص, stop talking. إن كنا لأنتن صواحب يوسف. You are the friends of Yusuf. What is the meaning of this statement? Here Ibn Hajar رحمه الله تعالى يعني mentioned that عائشة, okay, he means, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم means عائشة, you are صواحب يوسف, okay, the friends of يوسف. What is the meaning of friends of يوسف? Okay, it means the wife of the minister. The name, they mentioned that the name is زليخة. It is not a hadith, but this is common in the tafsir books. طيب. So what the Prophet ﷺ means? He means that you are saying something, but you mean another thing. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Yani, I understand what is your intention. I understand what is your point. Your point is that not because your father is soft man crying during the salah. No. Your point, and she mentioned that. Aisha said, because I am sure that anyone leads the salah in the place of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, people will hate him. And imagine the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم leading the salah 10 years in Medina. After 10 years, if anyone leads the salah, for sure he is less than the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So people will not like him. طيب. يعني, okay, maybe I give you example. It is example to understand. Imagine for 10 years, you are driving this brand of car. طيب. I'm not mentioning any brand, okay? Let's say it is 70,000 KD, 80,000 KD. Then after 10 years, okay, subhanAllah, there is something in your car. So now it is in the garage. They told you should keep your car in the garage 10 days. And we'll give you this car. So after driving 10 years, this your car, 70,000-80,000 KD. Now they give you a used car. And the new one, it is only 3,000 KD. For sure, even if it is a nice car, but for sure you'll hate this car. صح? You agree or you don't agree? You don't agree? This is your shit. خلاص. Drive the car, the 3,000. خلاص. Don't drive. طيب. So, okay, what is the point? The Prophet ﷺ mentioned the woman at the time of Yusuf, because the wife of the minister, she invited the woman come home to enjoy the food. But her intention is to see Yusuf alayhi salam. So she said something, she showed them something, but she meant another thing. So this is one of the hadith. Yani, of course, there are many hadith about the virtues of Abu Bakr, but this is a very great hadith about the virtue of Abu Bakr, and also as a proof that Abu Bakr is the leader of the Muslim Ummah after the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. طيب. Here there is an issue that there are more than one hadith about that Abu Bakr led the Salah during the time of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Or the scholars they mention there are two companions the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم prayed behind them. One of them Abu Bakr and the other one Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf. And the other one Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf. Why? Because one day he was late صلى الله عليه وسلم. He was busy. So they started the Iqama, then Abd al-Rahman Auf led the Salah, then the Prophet ﷺ joined the second Raka'ah. Or he came later. طيب Abd al-Rahman Auf. And Abu Bakr also, he led the Salah, and the Prophet ﷺ was behind him. But there is a hadith that the Prophet ﷺ prayed behind him, and there is a hadith that the Prophet ﷺ, he led the Salah. The one who started the Salah, Abu Bakr. Then he led the Salah. So, how to join between these ahadith? Abu Hatim ibn Hibban rahimahullah mentioned that all these ahadith are authentic. But this happened more than one time. And we mentioned that the Prophet was very sick for a few days. Let's say 7 days or 9 days. Okay, 9 days. So how many fard salah? 45 salah. So two of the salah, the Prophet went out and he prayed with the jama'ah, but one of them he prayed behind Abu Bakr, and one of them he prayed as a leader for the salah. Okay? Here there is also he put a chapter here, very important chapter. He mentioned the love of Abu Bakr toward the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because this is subhanallah a common misconception. Okay, so يعني they show some da'i, they show you that Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah don't love the family of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, Ahlul Bayt. No, alhamdulillah, Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we love Ahlul Bayt, we love Ali, we love Al-Abbas, we love Ibn Abbas, Al-Fadl Abbas رضي الله تعالى, we love Fatima, no doubt, we love Al-Hasan, Al-Husayn, we love all of them. I mean the Muslims. Okay, because of some of Ahlul Bayt, non-Muslims, like Abu Lahab, not Muslim. We hate him. We curse him. طيب, he's in the hellfire. طيب, but we love Ahlul Bayt. طيب, but also, we don't put them beyond their level, more than their level. They are human beings and they are companions. We love them, no doubt, we should love them. Okay, but they are not prophets. They are not sinless. They are normal. They are human beings. They are human beings. طيب, one hadith, that Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى prayed العصر. After that he was walking and then he saw الحسن. طيب, يعني what يعني how was the age of الحسن during the time of Abu Bakr? Okay, يعني let's say when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم passed away, the age of الحسن was 6. And Abu Bakr lived 2 years, so let's say he's less than 8. Yeah, between 6 and 8. So he was a young boy. So when Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu saw Al-Hasan playing with the boys, he carried him on his shoulder. Then he said, he looks like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he doesn't look like Ali. And he looks like his grandfather, not father. طيب. And Ali was there and Ali was laughing radiallahu ta'ala. Also, Ibn Umar رضي الله تعالى said that Abu Bakr رضي الله said, أرقبه محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم في أهل بيته. Take care of the family of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. عائشة رضي الله تعالى عن said that Abu Bakr said, by Allah, the relatives of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم more beloved to me than my relatives. To have the connection with them. يعني they mentioned that there was something between Fatima رضي الله تعالى and Abu Bakr. طيب, but actually it was not a problem and it was not an enmity. Okay, Fatima رضي الله تعالى asked Abu Bakr, where is my inheritance from Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم? And Abu Bakr said, okay, I heard your father saying the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that we are as prophets لا نورث ما تركنا صدقة. What we left is charity. Our family should not inherit us. Whatever we leave, after us, this is for charity. خلاص. طيب. So take the issue as simple as that. She was thinking that she has a right, like other people. Abu Bakr told her the exception. What is the exception? That the prophets, okay, whatever they left after them, should go to charity. خلاص. As simple as that. No need to mention no Abu Bakr or Bristol. No need for that. And if there is a narration that she was upset with Abu Bakr, okay, yeah, and this cause mission, this is subhanAllah normal feeling. Because they are human beings. Yani we mentioned the hadith. Okay, Aisha and Zainab, Aisha and Hafsa radiallahu ta'ala, and whom are the wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam shouting. Okay, as human beings, this happens. Okay, so we should not exaggerate the things. We should not deny the hadith, the authentic hadith, and also we should not exaggerate. And also, we should not focus on these points. We put them under the microscope to make them bigger than their size. Subhanallah, I heard one da'iyah talking about Hassan Thabit, radiallahu ta'ala. The lecture more than 1 hour. So I heard maybe 15 minutes, maybe 20 minutes criticizing Hassan bin Thabit radiallahu ta'ala an, or talk about the point that he was coward, he was not brave, he was not doing jihad, and also he spoke bad about Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha and Safwan Mu'attal hit him. And number one, okay, he took very weak narrations. He mentioned Al-Waqidi, one of the imams of the Sira books. He said that Hassan did not attend any of the battles with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Of course, subhanAllah, what is the problem? The problem, like this da'iyah, when they show you, imagine when I tell you Al-Waqidi, one of the imam of Sira, khalas, you respect. But subhanAllah, this man, this da'iyah, deceiving, cheating. He should mention that the scholars of hadith don't accept the narrations of Al-Waqidi, because Al-Waqidi is not acceptable in hadith. Why he did not mention this? And we mention one narration, another narration, without mentioning the authenticity of these narrations. So we should be very careful. Especially when you speak about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then after that the companions, make sure that the chains are authentic. I mean, if you find something criticizing the companions, then he's saying, I'm telling you this to tell you that they are human beings. Habibi, we know they are human beings. We know the companions are human beings. But you should mention they are the best human beings. You put them down. Okay, subhanAllah, he put this and focusing that he was covered. How many times he mentioned, wallahi, I felt bad. Subhanallah. You should put the hadith when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam praised Hassan Thabit. He said to Hassan, Hassan was saying the poetry, sah? Defending Islam, praising Islam, praising the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, defending hadith in Sahih Muslim. He said, "Uhjuhum wa ruhul Qudus yu'ayyiduk." He was in the Masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he said to Hassan, attack the kuffar with your tongue. And Ruh al-Qudus, who is Ruh al-Qudus? Jibreel. And Ruh al-Qudus is supporting you. This hadith Sahih Muslim. You should mention this hadith and you should focus on this hadith. What is the point you mentioned? Was cover. He was not fighting. What is the point? Where is your proof from the authentic hadith? He did not mention it. So we should be careful when we speak about the companions. And also, if there is something, okay, no need to mention, there is something between this companion and another companion, there was fight. What is the point I give lecture, public lecture, maybe 200-300 people attended the lecture and YouTube and Instagram? What is the point to mention this point? Do you think that after the lecture, the people will love Hassan Thabit? They will not respect him. Our job is make people to respect the companions. Because when we make people to respect the companions, they respect deen. So this is very, very important, subhanAllah. Sorry, I should stop now. If you have questions, because I have duty. If you have questions. Any question? Alaykum salam. Concerning
the nine wives of the Prophet.
Sorry?
Concerning the nine wives of the Prophet.
You
have nine wives. And he shared to them daily one night per wife. So is it permissible for maybe someone having two or three wives? They can arrange maybe 3 days. Should it be one day for them? Or you can have it, okay, you three days, or 2 days like this, or
compulsory one
days for them.
Ma adri, Allahu alam. I don't know, sorry.
But the Prophet, one day.
The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was doing one day. But to make like a package, two days, 3 days, Allah alam, if this is allowed. Yanchu, no doubt. If they agree, this is allowed. Okay? No doubt. If they agree, okay, we accept that one week here. Okay? If they agree, no doubt. Okay? But can the husband oblige them? Allah Ta'ala. Okay? Jazakum Allah khair. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I don't know. Inshallah, we'll tell. Inshallah. Thanks.